Hello children, how are you? I hope you all are happy and healthy. Okay children, tell me, what is the time right now?
It's morning.
Yes, very good. That's right. So tell me then, what comes next?
Next to morning will be noon, then evening, then night, and then morning again.
Good, good. You people are very intelligent. So when do you wake up every day? In the morning? At noon, in the evening, or at night?
In the morning.
In the morning.
Yes, good. All the children wake up in the morning every day. Do all of you wake up at the same time, together, all at exactly the same time?
I wake up at 6 o'clock.
I wake up at 7 o'clock.
Oh, but how do you know? Do you know how to read the time by a clock?
No. When my mother wakes me up in the morning, she says, please get up, it's 7 o'clock.
But I know how to read time from a clock. It's easy. The hour hand tells us the time.
Okay. So tell me, what is the time by this clock?
It's 3. 3 o'clock.
Very good. Okay, Ashu. Now your turn. Tell me, what is the time by this clock?
It's 12.
No, Ashu, you need to look at the hour hand. See how many hands are there in the clock?
1, 2, 3.
Right. This fast moving hand tells us the seconds. Just leave it. We will look at the other two hands.
But I liked this one the most.
Yes, I also like it because it moves so fast. It completes one round in just 1 minute.
You have said it right, Ritik. But which hand is going to tell us the time? See, here we have two more hands.
Yes, one is smaller while the other one is bigger.
Yes, Ashu. This smaller one is the hour hand and this bigger one is the minute hand.
So now look at this clock and tell me the time.
7 hours and 12 minutes.
No, it's 7 o'clock. The hour hand is at 7 and the minute hand at 12. Minute hand at 12 means it is 7 o'clock.
Yes, Ritik, right again. Ashu, minute hand at 12 means it is a complete hour. See, the counting begins and ends at this point only. Would you please read these numbers for me? Both of you together.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Very good. 12 all together. So now look at this clock and Ashu will tell the time.
It's 10 o'clock because minute hand is at 12.
Very good, Ashu. That was right. Now let's ask a question to Ritik. So Ritik, tell me, what is the time by this clock?
Yes, I will tell. It is 2 o'clock here.
Correct. Ashu, now your turn. Look here at this clock.
It's 4 o'clock.
Very good. You all are amazing. Okay, Ritik, now look at this clock. What is the time here?
Here also 2 o'clock. No. The minute hand is not at 12. I know, it's not 2 o'clock.
That's right, it's not 2 o'clock. Then what is it?
That I don't know. The minute hand is at 6. What does it mean?
See, the bigger hand, that is the minute hand, has taken half a round of the clock and has reached at 6. It means half an hour more. So 2 and a half.
What does it mean? How many hours and how many minutes?
You tell me, how many minutes are there in an hour?
60 minutes.
So how many minutes in half an hour?
Half of 60, that is 30.
Correct. So time here is 2 hours and 30 minutes. 2:30. So let's see another clock.
Here the time is 4 hour and 30 minute, 4:30.
Yes, that's right. But here, our hand is not at 4. You are right, Ashu. So, Ritik, can you tell me why is it so?
Maybe because it's not 4 o'clock. Because at 4 o'clock, the our hand is exactly at 4.
You are right again. Here, all the children are very intelligent. I like you all very much. Look, 4 and then half an hour more. Thus, this our hand has also moved to the middle of 4 and 5. Guess what will happen at 5 o'clock, that is, after half an hour? After half an hour, it will reach at 5. Very good, Ashu. And where will be the bigger hand then? Half a round in half an hour. Will it be at 12? Yes, of course. And that will make 5 o'clock. Now come, see this clock and tell me the time. 7:30. 7 hours and half more. Okay, Ritik, your turn now.
Here, the time is 11 hours and 30 minutes. That is 11:30.
Good. Now see this clock.
12 hours and 30 minutes. That is 12:30.
Very good. Now suppose it's 3 o'clock by my watch. So tell me, what will be the time after 2 hours from now? What can you do to find the answer?
I know. After 2 hours, it will be 5 o'clock. 3, 4, 5.
That's right. How did you do that?
I simply added 2 to 3.
Good. Okay, Ritik, now tell me. If it is 10 o'clock by my watch, then what was the time 4 hours before?
Subtracting 4 from 10. It'll be 6. 6 o'clock.
Very good. Okay, now both of you tell me how many months are there in a year?
12 months.
And tell their names now.
January,
February,
March,
April,
May,
June,
July,
August,
September,
October,
November,
December.
That was fun.
Yes, and you know what? Your naming the months like that can also help us. Would you like to know how?
Yes, please tell us.
See, do you know how many days does each month have? I know about February. It has 28 days and sometimes 29. Oh wow, so you know that. Can you tell me when does it have 29 days? Sometimes. Yes, Ashu. And those sometimes come every 4 years. Like in 2020, February had 29 days. We also call it a leap year. Now it will happen again after 4 years. That is in 2024. And then after that, Ritik, you tell me.
After 4 years, that is in 2028. But you were telling us about the days in a month.
Yes, right. So you all know about February. It has 28 days and in a leap year, it has 29 days. In rest of the months, there are either 30 days or 31 days. See, first month was named by Ritik, January. It has 31 days. And after this, the months named by Ritik have 31 days. And those named by Ashu will have 30 days. But yes, do remember February. It will always have 28 or 29 days. So let's name them once again. And this time, along with the month's name, also say the number of days it has. So Ritik, please start.
January 31.
February 28 or 29.
March 31.
April 30.
May 31.
June 30.
July 31.
Stop.
Here we need to stop once and change the order. Now, the months named by Ashu will have 31 days and the months named by Ritik will have 30 days. If you got it, then let's move further.
Yes, yes. So, August will have 31 days.
September, 30.
October, 31 days.
November, 30 days.
December, 31 days.
I hope you will remember that, children. First, 31, then 30. And after July, this order gets changed once. August will have 31 days and the next month will have 30 days. Then it will go on like this till end. And about February, you know very well.
February we'll always remember. But this 30, 31 is difficult to remember.
Oh, is that so? Ashu, do you also feel the same? If yes, then come. Let me tell you another very interesting way out. Very easy and very interesting. Look here, at your hands. Make fists of both your hands. Keep them both close to each other. Can you see some bones here? You can touch to feel them.
Yes, yes, we can see.
And this low space in between two bones?
Yes, yes, this too.
Okay, so just start naming the months one by one, starting from the first bone. The months whose name lie on the bone will have 31 days, and those lying on the space in between will have 30 days. After one hand, continue with the other one. And do remember February.
Yes, 28 or 29 days, we remember.
So come, let's do it. January, February, March, April, May, June, July. Now the other hand. August, September, October, November, December. So how's that? Easy or difficult?
No, this one is really easy and interesting too. I liked it. Why don't you ask us about the days in various months? We'll tell the answers.
Oh wow, that will be great. Okay, let me ask. So tell me, how many days are there in March?
January, February, March, 31. 31.
And in June?
January, February, March, April, May, June, 30 days. 30 days. Is that always so every year?
Yes, of course. Come, let's cross-check it with the help of a calendar. Look, here is a calendar. Can you tell me the year?
2018. It's clearly written here in such big numbers.
Yes, right. So tell me, how many months were there in 2018?
12. There are always 12 months in every year. I know that.
Yes, yes, but we must check it. Are there 12 months in this calendar also? And also point them to show where they are.
Let me show you. Here is January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December, all 12.
Are there also the names of the days of week?
Yes, yes. Here, see. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. The names are written in the short form.
And below them?
This counting, that's the number of days.
Yes. Can you tell me the day by looking at a particular date? Like what was the day on 3rd of January?
Yes, that's easy. Above 3, Wednesday is written. So that day was Wednesday.
Very good. After checking the number of days of each month, we will play a game of calendar.
Okay.
So come, let's first write the names of months with 30 or 31 days separately. Then we will match it with the calendar.
Okay. So first, the months with 31 days here.
And the ones with 30 days here, this side.
January here. February, let's leave it aside. Then March, April, May, June, July.
So, the months with 31 days are January, March, May, July, August, October and December. Total 7. And the months with 30 days are April, June, September and November. Only 4.
And this calendar also shows the same. So let's play now.
Yes, yes, we will just play. But first, tell me when is your birthday?
12 March.
So find it out in the calendar. Now tell me, what was the date 7 days before this?
7 days before, it was 5th March.
Very good. And after 7 days?
7 days after 12, it was 19th.
Very good. Ashu, now you tell me, when was the Children's Day? On 14th of November. So find it out in calendar. November 14th, here. Good. Now tell me, what was the date 7 days before Children's Day? Show the date in calendar only. Here, 7th of November, right above the 14th of November. Very good. And after 7 days? 21, right below 14th. Right. In every rectangle, the number written in a column differ by 7 each. So let's start the game now. I have this hollow square. I will keep it here on the calendar like this. See, it has covered some numbers. You just need to add them and tell me the answer. Every time you will add just 3 numbers. Once downwards, then left to right, then slanting from this side, and then slanting from the other side. Whoever will add first will win. So let's start now. And yes, one more thing. I will write the correct answer on this piece of paper. Here, in advance. And in the end, we will match your answer with this. So here, I have kept the square. Now start adding. Downwards, these 3 numbers in the middle column only. Then from left to right, here also the 3 numbers in the middle row only. And then 3 numbers slanting from the left. And then 3 numbers slanting from right. So 4 additions in all. So do it quickly and tell me the answer.
I have done it. Every time the answer was 45. I don't know how.
Yes, Ritik. See, the right answer written on this paper is also 45. Let's do it once again. This time, I am placing the square here. So hurry up, start adding. And the right answer goes here on this paper.
I have won. The answer is 30, all sides.
Yes, right. 30 each side. And look, here 30 on my paper too. How do you write the answer in advance? It's for you to find out. Let's do it again. Add it quickly.
Done. The answer is 60 and I got it. Now I can tell the answer in advance. We just need to multiply the middle number by 3. Because the numbers above and below it always add up to its twice.
Very good, Ritik. You got it. Okay, Ashu, now you tell me. If in place of 3, we take 5 numbers that occur in a straight line, then I think we will have to multiply the middle term by 5. Wait, let me check. Please tell me the numbers. Any 5 occurring in a straight line, like this. 2, 8, 14, 20, 26. 14 fives are 70. And their sum? Yes, that's also 70. Yes, it's right. We will have to multiply the middle term by 5. Good. So now let's play another game. Here is a small stone. Throw it in the air and clap for once before catching it back. Very good. Now clap twice. Now three times. Good. Now both of you do it together. Whoever will clap for more times will win. Also tell me now, when we throw a pebble in air, how much time does it take to reach back? A few seconds, a few minutes, a few hours, or a few days?
Only a few seconds.
Okay, so answer a few of my questions here. You need to tell me how much time it takes to do these things. A few minutes, a few hours, or a few days. Okay, so taking bath.
A few minutes.
Setting off curd.
A few hours.
Ripening of fruits on a tree.
A few days.
A day in school.
A few hours.
Doing homework.
A few hours.
Recess time.
A few minutes.
Climbing a tree.
A few minutes.
A match of cricket. 2020.
A few hours.
A visit to some other city.
A few days.
Eating food.
A few minutes.
Very good. All correct. Okay, so now let me tell you an interesting story. It is a story with topsy-turvy time. As the sun sets, Sumana wakes up. What a lovely evening. She washes her face fast in 2 hours and runs out. She goes straight to the bird's nest. She has been watching the eggs for the last few months. She was waiting for the baby birds to come out. But before she can blink her eyes in a week, a cat jumps onto the tree. The mother bird cries loudly, and Sumana rushes to shoo away the cat. As the cat jumps, it hits the big green mango. Dum! In 2 days, it is on the ground. Oh, how sad! The mango is still not fully ripe. It needed one more year to become sweet. Suddenly, Sumana's sister calls out, "Are you still not hungry? Has your stomach clock gone to sleep? Come and eat hot upma for dinner." Wasn't that funny? You must have guessed that some of the words were wrong. Now, choose the correct word from this box and change the wrong ones. So children, for some more of such interesting questions, open your book of mathematics. The name of the chapter is The Time Goes On, and the page number is 95. Here you will find a lot of interesting questions and stories. Read them all quickly and do all of the questions. This is your homework. And we will meet in the next chapter now. Thank you. Have a nice day.